Greetings. Matthew 6:19. Do not lay up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy or corrupt, and where thieves break through or break in and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Your heart will be with your treasure. So where are you laying up your treasure? 1 Timothy 6:17. Instruct those who are rich in the present age not to be conceited and not to put their hope in the uncertainty of wealth, but in God, who richly provides all things for us to enjoy. Instruct them to do good, to be rich in good works, and to be generous and ready to share, treasuring up or laying up for themselves a firm foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of that which is truly life. Where are you laying up your treasure? Where is your heart? Do you look longingly for the return of the Lord? 2 Timothy 4:8. From now on, the crown of righteousness is laid up for me, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who crave his appearing. Do you crave and long for his appearing? I used to mock Christians who were so heavenly minded they were no earthly good. I think we need balance so we may walk in this world even though we are not of this world. 1 John 2:15. Do not love the world or the things of the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Are you living for this world, or are you living for the next? I was driving home from work last night, and a particular song came up on my radio, Gangsta Paradise by Coolio. I have to be honest, I see no redeeming social value in C-rap music. It is angry and largely promotes senseless violence and wanton hedonism. But driving home as I began to contemplate the hate in C-rap music, I had another thought. The human angst that produces hate and rage and anger is tragic. But we as Christians must not hate those who hate, even when they hate us. Matthew 5:9, but I say to you, do not resist the one who is evil. But if anyone slaps you on the right cheek, turn to him the other also. How can we love those who hate us? How can we forgive those who attack and destroy our lives here? And this question goes to the heart of how Christians deal with Islam's evil in the world. Matthew 28:10, do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Instead, fear the one who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Do you believe in what you say you believe in? If you believe Christ is Lord, you have eternal life. You will live even though you die. John 11:25, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one believing in me, even if he should die, he will live. Think about what that really means. All of us will die at some point. It may be of a natural cause, a disease, or murder by a Muslim terrorist. Even if he should die, he will live. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that everyone who believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." John 5:21, "For just as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so also the Son gives life to whom he wishes." Colossians 3:4, "When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory." This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is the good news that we no longer must fear death. The end of this life is not the end of existence. 1 Corinthians 15:50. "Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither does corruption inherit incorruption." Right out of the gate, your body, your flesh and blood, needs to be worried. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed." All means all who believe Jesus is Lord. We shall not all sleep. The phrase, "we shall not all sleep," means some Christians will be alive when Jesus returns. But we shall all be changed. All Christians, those dead and those alive, will all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, "For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed." Those dead Christians will be raised from the dead and given incorruptible bodies, and we shall be changed. And we, Paul includes himself among the alive, shall also be changed. "For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality." Living Christians will receive their eternal bodies. We will put on our immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that was written, "Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory?" Hosea 13:14, "Shall I ransom them from the power of Sheol? Shall I redeem them from death? O death, where are your thorns? O Sheol, where is your sting?" Are you living for this life, afraid of death, unconvinced of your eternal salvation? That fear makes it impossible to love to the point of loss. Please do not receive this as judgment. I do not know you or what you face. I also know I too face these same emotions and fears. It is why listening to Coolio brought me to tears as I drove. Am I living my life in fear or anger against those who need salvation? No person is 100% evil. Worldviews and philosophies all have some measure, no matter how small, of a sliver of truth. Ultimately, however, they all fail because they cannot redeem the soul and spirit of mankind. Do we place value in what we believe? Do we not grasp the value of what we believe? Matthew 13:45, again, "The kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking fine pearls, And upon finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. Is what we believe worth sharing? You must decide, brother, for yourself if you agree. If deep in your heart you think your form of Christianity is a waste of time, I encourage you to seek to fall in love with Messiah again. We should be willing to share with all men. Not only willing, but able to share a coherent and cogent rational explanation for our belief. 1 Peter 3:15. But in your hearts honor Christ the Lord as holy, always being prepared to make a defense to anyone who asks you for a reason for the hope that is in you, yet do it with gentleness and respect. You see, if you prize the next life, you will want to share the next life. Maybe you do not feel equipped to share the accurate gospel. 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that doesn't need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. The Comforter, the Holy Spirit in you, is more than able to teach you all things. John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. I think I'm going to need another video to continue this topic. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.